So let us discuss shortcuts for deciding ROC here. I'm giving two shortcuts. Directly you can draw ROC in this. First one is right sided signal will be having sigma greater than P, and left sided signal will be having sigma less than P, where P is real part of coefficient of T in power of E. That means if you take this example, e power of p plus j omega t, here e power of pt, this is the real part, right? Where p is real part of the coefficient of t in power of e. Okay, in power of e, and p is coefficient of t, right? So this p we want, real part. So you need to use for drawing ROC this p. Let us see some example. Assume p equal to 2. Here e power of 2t. For right sided signal, you assume this is e of t. So this is right sided signal. For this right sided signal, you will be having sigma greater than 2. So right sided signal will be having right side ROC, right? So this 2 is directly we are using, and sigma is greater than 2 means this completely ROC. And this is left sided signal, sigma is less than 2. For example, this one is e power of 2t e of minus t. This is left sided signal, right? So in this, real part is this one, 2. So I am using this one. So this is ROC for left sided signal. You got completely left side. See, this is a stable signal, because in this j omega axis is included. If you draw this signal, how it will be? This will be, it will come like this, right? This signal. If you draw this one, it is exponentially increasing. So it is not absolutely integrable because it doesn't have a j omega axis. It is absolutely integrable because it is included j omega axis. So for this signal, we already solved Fourier transform, but we didn't solve Fourier transform for this signal. Next, let us see, draw the ROC of the given signals. X of t equal to e power of 2t u of minus t. So how it will be this one? Is it right side signal or left side signal? It is a left sided signal. So for this, sigma less than 2. For left side signal, we need to use sigma less than, here real part is 2, right? 2 I am using. So 0, 1, 2. So this is what ROC for this. Clear? If you draw this signal, so it is left sided signal. And absolutely integrable signal. Right? Because it included j omega axis. So directly ROC we are drawing from this signal. So let us see this signal. This is right sided signal or left sided signal? It is a right sided signal. In this, real part is minus 2 and imaginary part is plus 3, right? So I am separating e power of minus 2t into e power of 3j t e of t, right? Right sided signal, left sided signal? Because you have u of t means it is a right sided signal. You can decide whether it is right side signal or left side signal by using u of t only. If you have u of minus t, you can tell it is a left side signal. If you have u of t, then it is a right side signal. So right side signal, in this p is minus 2, right? For right side signal, what is the condition? Sigma greater than p, right? So here sigma greater than minus 2. So let us draw ROC. So minus 2 is right side signal. Sigma greater than minus 2 means this side, right? So this is sigma greater than minus 2. ROC content j omega axis means it is a absolutely integrable signal. And this is right sided signal, right? Let us see example 3. Here x of t equal to e power of 2t u of t plus e power of minus 3t u of minus t has given. Here we have a 2 signal. It is a x1 of t. And here this is x2 of t, we'll assume. So for x1 of t, what is ROC? And x2 of t, what is ROC? For x1 of t, it is the right sided signal or left sided signal? It is the right sided signal, right? It is a left sided signal. Because here you have a u of minus t. Here you have a u of t, right? For right sided signal, here what is p? 2, right? Here p is minus 3. For right sided signal, sigma is greater than p. P here 2. Here sigma is less than minus 3, right? If you draw ROC for this, j omega, this is 1, 2, 2 greater than, right? So, ROC for this signal, and let us draw ROC for this signal. So, sigma less than minus 3 means it will be this side. So, in these two ROCs, any common ROC you have? Here assume ROC 1 and this is you assume ROC 2. So we need to add these two signals, right? So here result is ROC 1 intersection ROC 2. Means we require a common ROC in these two. We don't have any common ROCs, right? One is going this side, one is coming this side, right? This signal doesn't have a Laplace transform. So, Laplace transform. Does not exist. Because. In this. Don't have a. Common. ROC. This is one problem from Laplace transform. So let us see example 4. X of t e power of 2t e of minus t. Here only this part we change. This is we made to left sided signal. And e of minus t both are left sided signal. So here this is left sided signal. This also left sided signal, right? In this p equal to 2, in this p equal to minus 3. So sigma less than 2 in this sigma less than minus 3, right? If you draw this one, sigma and j omega 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So sigma less than 2 means ROC is all these values, right? Because it is left side signal and ROC will be having left side. That's what you got sigma less than 2. And sigma less than minus 3 means this is minus 3 and this one is this side, right? So this is ROC 1. And this is ROC 2. ROC one intersection ROC, two if perform, what you are getting? Sigma less than minus 3 only, right? Common. So from this, both you are getting common, right? So Laplace transform exists for ROC sigma less than minus 3 for this problem. If you take example 5, x of t equal to e power of 2t e of minus t plus e power of minus 3t e of t. So this is left sided signal. This is right sided signal. For this p equal to 2, for this p equal to minus 3, sigma less than 2 this one, and this is sigma greater than minus 3, right? So if you draw for this, so in this sigma less than 2 means this is completely this side. In this sigma greater than minus 3 means this completely this side. So common point is only this strip, right? So Laplace transform exists for ROC here minus 3 less than sigma less than 2 for this problem. Thank you.